Hello. Welcome to Shaun Academy. Today in this video we're going to learn how to start a cigarette business. My name is James and I will be your business consultant in this video. Now, before we start a cigarette business, let's take a closer look at what goes into starting one and how we can make yours profitable. There are numerous factors to consider before deciding how to start a cigarette business. Not only is the business age restricted, but it is also governed by a plethora of rules and regulations. It is critical that you enter the process fully aware of the legal implications and that your company complies with all of them. After you've gotten the difficult things out of the way, starting a new cigarette business can be profitable. Owners can combine it with liquor and wine sales, or even add a small lounge area with food and drink service. You have many options for making your store unique and successful. But first, let's go over the steps to starting a new cigarette business. 1. Create a budget and a business plan. The first step in running a successful business is to plan ahead of time. The best way to get started is with a thorough business plan. When creating a great cigarette business plan, there are several key areas to consider: A. Explain who you are. B. Explain what you intend to sell. C. Determine your target audience. D. Demonstrate what makes you unique. E. Outline your operational strategy. F. Explain how you intend to market. G. Monitor future cash flow. Starting with a business plan will help you and your team stay organized while also increasing your chances of receiving business loans or other outside investment. 2. Determine which licenses you'll require. In such a heavily regulated industry, obtaining all necessary licenses and permits prior to opening is critical. Your state government will require you to obtain a retail tobacco license. This allows you to legally sell tobacco and tobacco-related products. The application is usually accompanied by a one-time licensing fee. Approved applications are valid for 1 year and cannot be transferred to other businesses or locations. If you own a cigarette shop with multiple locations, you must obtain tobacco licenses for each location, though you can usually submit a single application for all locations. To sell tobacco products across state lines, you must obtain a tobacco wholesaler license from each state where you intend to sell. At each location, all required licenses must be prominently displayed. You must also keep all receipts and invoices for wholesale cigarette and tobacco products purchased in the previous 4 years. Failure to comply with both of these requirements will result in steep fines from your city-state governments. 3. Open a business bank account and file taxes. In addition to the business plan, you'll need to determine the legal structure of your company. There will be four primary options for the majority of cigarette businesses. 1. Sole proprietorship, a business with only one owner. 2. Partnership, two or more owners. 3. Limited liability company, a tax structure similar to the one described above, but with additional safeguards. 4. Corporation, there is no actual owner, and all taxes are paid through the corporation. The majority of cigarette companies will be limited liability companies. This should be one of the first things you figure out if you have a team and other investors. After you've decided on the type of business you'll run, you must register with your state and the federal government to establish your tax structure. 4. Register your company name. Begin by checking the registry with your local government to ensure that the name of your business is not already in use. The majority of small businesses will select a doing business's name. This means that while your actual business may be registered in your own name, your DBA will be different. Customers will recognize your store by its DBA. Remember that DBAs offer no legal protection against other businesses using the same name. If you are concerned about copyright issues, you must contact the United States Trademark and Patent Office. If you found this video useful, please show your appreciation by clicking the like button. Also, let us know in the comments if you'd like us to make a long, comprehensive follow-up video to learn more about how to start a cigarette business. Also, don't forget to click the subscribe button to see more videos from Shaun Academy, an extension for education.